Mike Racine, one of my oldest friends in comedy. And we just looked at an article here. It says, I'm dating a 23-year-old woman who looks like an 8-year-old. I'm not a creep.
Yeah, nobody thought that.
Show this article.
Sometimes old To Catch a Predator clips will come up on my TikTok.
Yeah.
And it's really funny. I mean, you forget that how wild that show was.
It was so fun.
But they all thought they were, like, going to get to go home afterwards.
Yeah. Well, they thought it was, like, a warning.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, they were like, I get it.
Yeah. No, you're right. I'm sorry. No, I won't tell an 8-year-old boy I want to suck his cock ever again.
I'm wrong here.
Yeah.
Never happened again.
Thank you. Yeah.
Now, this guy's dating. He's 23, and the woman's 23.
Yeah.
But she looks 8.
It's not really a story.
I mean, what's the big deal?
Yeah.
She looks like this. This is the thing. She literally looks like she's...
She looks like a ventriloquist.
Yeah, she's a... And TLC, of course, has done a show about her. Because why wouldn't TLC? And her name is Shauna Rae. And there's something wrong with her, clearly. People don't understand that I am an adult.
She's from Long Island.
She's from Long Island. She was born with brain cancer. The second season of the show premieres and follows Rae as she looks for love and considers whether she wants to pursue a college degree. Looks for love. So this is To Catch a Predator.
Yeah.
Now.
The show is just called My 8-Year-Old Girlfriend.
Yeah, My 8-Year-Old Bride.
That's the hook. Yeah.
I mean, this is nuts. Can you imagine if you brought her?
She does look like a child.
Can you imagine if you brought her to your parents and you said, this is my girlfriend, Shauna Rae?
Yeah.
If you look at me, you see an 8-year-old, she told the Post. But if you took the time to look at the details of my face, my hands, the maturity of my body, if you take the time to actually talk to me, you really understand that I'm a 23.
But I'll tell you what, I have tits and my pussy gets wet. Okay?
What is the dude, like, what's his story?
She's kind of attractive, though. She's not bad looking.
Yeah, I mean, what's the problem here? I mean, look at this photo. Look at that photo.
It's just the way she's dressing. She's got to dress a little older.
I mean, he's a pedophile.
Yeah.
You think?
Yeah, but that's the best way to be a pedophile, don't you think?
It's the best. Look how happy he is.
Yeah.
He found it. Like, look how thrilled he is. He's like, wait a minute,
He's like, God.
She's like, I have this condition. I'm actually 23. He's like, yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
He goes in the chat room. He goes, guys, I found a 23-year-old. She looks like she's 8. And the guy's like, man, I just molest kids in my neighborhood.
Yeah. He's like writing. He goes, listen, guys, the thing that we all want does exist.
Yeah. Yeah.
You can have your cake and eat it too.
Yeah. I do a bit about how, like, the day you realize that you're not a pedophile, that's like a great day in your life.
Right.
You know?
It's weird to see.
Yeah.
And it's unfortunate but she deserves.
She probably gets carded a lot, I guess. Right?
Carded? She's not allowed in the thing. Yeah. They'll go, this is a fake ID. She'll go, it's a government issued ID. They'll go, get the fuck out.
Yeah.
It is not. I mean, at the end of the day, I think that she deserves love.
Yeah. Yeah. Does she have a condition or something?
She has a condition.
Uh-huh.
I mean, she has to.
Yeah.
Right?
The condition's called 8-year-old pussy syndrome. And they met.
I mean, let's hear what he says.
The way me and Shauna met was, I saw the first season of the show. I was really inspired by her emotional strength.
The way me and Shauna met was, I went to Thailand and I said, hey, are there any 8-year-olds in this hotel where I can get some action?
And then, it's just subtitles.
No.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's sad because this is a girl who deserves companionship. She's 23 years old.
Yeah.
The problem is you're inherently suspect of the guy that wants to take her out.
Well, you just can't, like, kiss her in public. I mean,
it's every single restaurant. Is this your daughter?
Restaurant, yeah.
Is this your daughter?
Yeah.
You know?
Right.
Imagine.
Can't take her to Nobu.
If you go to the honeymoon suite with her, the police will be called. They will call the police.
Uh-huh.
So it's difficult.
Yeah.
Now she's 23. She needs to find somebody that has her condition.
Sure.
But they probably don't look good.
Or just like an 8-year-old boy.
Or she needs to start dating an 8-year-old.
They're nice and horny.
But they can't dick her down.
Yeah.
She wants to get dicked down.
Yeah, right.
And this guy is willing to dick her down.
When do you start getting boners? Like around like 13? like
probably 12 or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
I imagine, but still she wants a man. She's a fully formed 23-year-old in her brain.
Right.
So she's looking for a guy.
Yeah.
And the problem is, look, go up for a second. Look at this. Look at this. Hold on.
He looks so young. Oh. Who's that guy?
I don't know.
Shauna's blind date with a firefighter.
Yeah, let's watch this.
So they have like the same condition, I guess.
I'm a little nervous.
What the fuck?
I'm excited to meet someone who's gone through something.
By the way, what? Like, Mike.
Just date other kids.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Your parents,
yeah,
and coming home and saying, "This is my girlfriend, Shauna Rae."
Yeah,
look.
Hi, nice to meet you, I'm Tom. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
By the way, stop this for a second. What the fuck is TLC doing?
Yeah.
Can we arrest the people that work at TLC? Can we arrest the executives that work at TLC?
She's like, some people think I'm 8, but you know, this mouth ain't 8 years old. This mouth does things that only a 47-year-old woman knows how to do.
Don't worry about me. My mouth knows exactly what to do. I'm no 8-year-old.
Let's get you in my pussy.
Let's watch this.
Sure.
Beautiful. Come on. Right this way.
But what? This
when
isn't
Thomas
even
first
like.
Came around the corner, I was like, oh, he's taller. I was like, oh, he's taller. That there's already a foot difference. I was like, we'll see how the similarities are there.
People who watch this are so are just sick. You know? My wife likes to send me Instagram reels. Yeah. She sent me one the other day. It was like, it started off, it goes, this child's eyes were glued shut. Women like to watch, like we watch like beheading videos,
right?
You know, and people shitting or whatever.
Sure.
But the stuff that women watch is actually way more sick.
It's sick.
You know?
They want to, well, the whole.
Disability kids, disabled kids.
Well, the thing, there's shows on TikTok that show the most deformed people that are all in like relationships.
Yeah.
And it really makes you feel sad if you're not in a relationship because you see people who are like truly like it'll just be a head with feet and they'll be like, this person is in a relationship. You'll be some guy in India who's like a snake. It's the body of a snake
And his wife's a mongoose.
Yeah, and then you go, and this is his wife, and she's like a normal looking person.
So this is the boyfriend meeting the parents.
Oh yeah, this is great.
Sean, now it doesn't help that her bedroom is decorated like an 8-year-old.
Yeah.
And what do y'all plan on doing?
Make sushi.
I've been talking to this guy named Dan recently, and we've been talking for a bit, and he's actually visited once before.
What are you supposed to feel watching this? What is the audience? What is like, what do they want you to like get out of this? You know?
I mean,
how do we know she's not an 8-year-old?
By the way, what if it comes out she's 8?
Yeah.
The whole thing about her being 23, that was a lie.
That's the season finale.
To
show that she's 8.
They're like, we're kidding around.
Yeah.
You are a pedophile. TLC.
Dan, remember how Shauna always needed lube and she would cry after you came inside of her? She would just... Yeah, that's because she was a kid.
Here at TLC.
It's Nathan for You. It's the new Nathan for You.
It's a new season of Nathan for You. Let's watch a little bit more of this.
He's been out this long, and this is also be the first time he's meeting my mom.
So how often do you guys talk?
I don't know, it's every day.
But then why are the parents like vetting him like they're like a Muslim family?
You know what it is? The parents know that whoever walks through that door is a problem.
Is a problem.
They know whoever walks through that door is a normal male is not dating her.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Shauna.
Yeah.
A normal male.
Right.
Who doesn't have any problems.
Right.
Is not going to date a girl who appears to be 8.
Oh, so you guys are going to Chili's tonight? Can I just see your browsing history really quick?
Yeah. Tell us about your last relationship.
Yeah.
What was your last relationship?
I'm not really irritated by my family when they bring up those future questions. I haven't talked about it with Dan. I'm kind of letting it go as it may. But it's nice to kind of try to see if he can answer it. Why do we have to label anything?
So it's a question mark or...
Now what are you going to do in 30 years when she looks like she's 12?
Yeah, I just don't understand. Number one, is this girl going to live?
Yeah. Right.
That's a question, right?
Sure. That is
how long is she going to live?
Mm-hmm.
like, I don't know. She has some type of condition, mm-hmm. and it may be fatal. Mm-hmm. That's kind of weird. They're making sushi. Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's kind of a red flag.
Odd.
Just go get it. Just go support the Asian community.
Why would you make sushi? Well, you know why? He doesn't want the embarrassment of uh-huh. sitting down at a table with her.
Right.
And having every Japanese person.
Yeah. You might get your head cut off with a samurai sword. Yeah. Because they're really into honor over there.
Well, they'll think it's the daughter and they'll be like, happy birthday.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right. I mean, let's just a little bit more because this is fascinating.
Happens.
Okay.
I definitely think all those questions scared Dan just a little bit. Like, I feel like he tensed up just slightly when my mom walked in.
Just cut.
You think that at some point you might settle down and kind of base yourself in one place and then travel when you...
I don't know. I'll see. I think traveling will always be a big part of my life. So I'll always be going somewhere.
I'm really not going.
Yeah, I'm out running the police.
Yeah, I just really like places like Indonesia, Thailand,
you know,
Myanmar.
A lot traveling because sometimes I get a knock on the door and it's a bunch of men and they want to see my computer. So, you know, a lot to get around.
Afghanistan's really fun this time of year. I got a friend who's a warlord.
Yeah, he's got a beautiful house in Kabul. This is not, is this her sister?
I think so.
I think
so. Any questions?
I'm tired now.
I'm like, they're just rapid firing questions at you.
Well, I guess what would be, yeah, I'm gonna ask another
more
one.
More questions.
What would be the expectation if you and Shauna...
And one daughter looks like she's eight, the other voted for Hillary Clinton.
Get along.
If something buds?
Yeah, if something buds. Is the expectation, like, for her to travel with you, or...?
Yeah, one thing I'd love to gift to Shauna is the ability to see the world in different cultures. Different
yeah, the
places,
planes so. Are tight and are very small, and the hotel rooms are very small, and they have rules in those countries about who you can travel with.
You know, they don't really have the attitude like they do here. I don't get the kind of looks. I'm trying to take your daughter out for a nice meal.
It's mostly business that I do over there.
Thailand, they treat people like human beings. They're not fucking nosy about everything.
I'd love to show her somewhere amazing around the world.
I think Dan would be a really good match for Shauna because he's very smart, adventurous. Shauna's smart. Not very adventurous. I think that he could pull her out of the comfort zone, but still make her feel safe.
Jesus Christ.
Look at this lineup of people. Look at this lineup of freaks on TLC. What the fuck is... Are they conjoined
twins? Are they going to bring out the Indian doctor from My 600-Pound Life and go, you are a pedophile, my friend. My friend, you want to fuck children.
This is very bad, my friend.
No, I don't actually. She's 23. Yeah, no, but she looks like she's 8. Stop. Cut the bullshit. Stop with the bullshit.
But I would love to just go into a development meeting at TLC.
Yeah.
Would there be anything off limits?
Can we do that? Can we do that while I'll extend my trip?
Yeah, tell Deb.
Deb, me and Tim are pitching. Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, is there anything off limits? Apparently not.
I don't think so.
Is there anything you could pitch these people that would give them pause?
I don't know. Let's find out tomorrow.
I mean, it's like the craziest.
Get your people on the phone.
I am Shauna Rae.
This is the story of two Down syndrome twins who are in love.
Right. No, nothing makes these people stop.
Yeah.
There's not one thing that would make them go, ugh, I don't know.
Yeah.
You know? They're conjoined twins.
Yeah.
And one of them's got to go.
Yeah.
TLC. It's like the craziest fucking thing.
I guess it's fun to watch train wrecks like that. I mean, I watch a lot of like kitchen nightmares, and that's fun watching people with these horrible restaurants just run their restaurants into the ground and then get yelled at.
Oh, it's great.
That's fun. But
it's great. Oh.
Brain cancer left her with dwarfism.
That's what it is. Yeah.
She's got tattoos trying to look older.
Oh, my God. They just think it's a temporary tattoo.
It doesn't help that she's dressing like a kid, too. She should go to Ann Taylor Loft to get some sensible, you know? some sensible work clothes.
I'm sorry, that photo is the craziest thing.
So you teaching your daughter how to paddleboard?
She's more lover.
Something like that, mate. Something like that.
She's more lover. Like, one day he just has enough and he just looks at the guy. He's like, she's more lover. Oh, my God. I am Shauna Rae. God, help us. Well, have you heard they closed down Splash Mountain?
No.
This is a big thing. Splash Mountain was very a racist ride, I think.
Because it's Song of the South.
Song of the South.
Yeah.
And you'd go through it, and it was like...
It was like separate water fountains are good.
It was like Briar Rabbit.
Now, apparently that's like the most racist Disney movie. Like they won't even... Because all the Disney movies... Because I watch a lot of Disney Plus.
Yeah.
All the Disney movies go, they give you warnings in the front. Every single one. It'll be like 101 Dalmatians. And they go, we're sorry for the racism in this movie.
Right.
But they don't play... They don't... Song of the South, it's been like wiped from existence.
They won't even let it anywhere.
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 Now, when did that come out? Like this 1970s?
Look up Song of the South.
Because I thought it was like the 50s or something, but I think it was...
I think it's the stereotype of like a southern...
It doesn't portray the black community very well.
No, I think it's just kind of like outdated stereotypes. Yeah.
He's like, zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay.
That's a great song, though.
I really miss being a slave. I didn't have to.
Zippity-doo-dah.
Oh, 1946. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, why did I think it was later? Zippity-doo-dah,
zippity-ay.
And the CEO's, his name is Bob Iger. That's two letters off from the N-word.
Yeah, Bob Iger.
Maybe they should think about that.
That's a real problem.
Yeah.
So Song of the South is... See if you can get something up from Song of the South. Let's see how bad it is. There's got to be...
It's got to be something, yeah.
On YouTube has to probably have a...
Now, that's like the best ride at Disney World, though.
It was the best ride.
Yeah.
And you would go through this Song of the South Village.
Yeah.
And they would play like zippity-doo-dah. Yeah. And then it was a log flume.
A log flume.
Right.
That's all it was.
That's all it was. Yeah. What will it be now? Just like is it going to be like an explanation of how the projects was built as you're going through it?
Yeah, probably.
It'd be like Robert Moses. Yeah. Like you'd be sitting there and they'd be like, Robert Moses made the overpass.
It's going to be the Alex English ride.
Yeah, yeah. Robert Moses made it. The overpass is too short for buses to go out to Long Island, bringing African Americans to their new homes in the suburbs. And you're like sitting there, like, oh God, this is.
Zip, zippity, biddy, da, da, zip, zippity, yay. Wonderful feeling this way. Zoom, 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 zoom,
nothing offensive about
it's
this.
Actually, hold on. I mean,
there's nothing wrong with
it. Doesn't seem crazy. Like, here's the thing. I know it's racist.
Yeah.
But at first look.
No, I bet if you watch the whole movie,
I'm sure it's horrible.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's horrible.
But this is
first
the song
look is like
knows.
A charming guy singing.
Yeah.
And animation.
It must be really bad for Disney to wipe it.
It must be horrible for Disney to wipe it. Yeah. Or it's a lot of pressure. Mm-hmm. I'm sure there's outdated stereotypes that are very bad, and they're kind of, let's see this, maybe. I don't know. This seems a little.
He's like, General Sherman was a war criminal.
The place where you was born and raised?
That I is.
You mean leaving for good?
That I, ow! Now see that? That old brow patch ain't brought me nothing but trouble. Ow! And more trouble. This where the trouble is, and this the place I belongs away from.
Don't you know you can't run away from trouble?
Well, I'm glad there ain't gonna be no trouble.
There ain't no place that far.
Just the same, I done made up my mind, and I ain't never coming back. Well, so long, Uncle Remus.
Sure hope you know what you was doing.
Don't worry about me. I can take care of myself.
Imagine it's like 1946. You're like on a date, and she's like, "So what do you do for a living?" And you're like, "Oh, I'm an actor." And she's like, "Oh, have you done anything I've seen?" And you're like, "Yeah, I was in this movie called Song of the South, where I played an illiterate rabbit."
Yeah, there was a movie that Disney did about the South. She's like, "Really? Yeah, I don't know. You know, where can I see it?" Well, I don't know. The dark web. Where can you even get "You Can't Get Song of the South"? Yeah, so here we go. Why is it considered racist? This is good. Adults and children alike will be able to appreciate the magic of visiting a Walt Disney theme park. You get to meet an iconic cast of characters and enjoy thrilling rides, inspiring a sense of, okay, shut up. The decision to replace the ride was made in 2020 in response to its theme. Splash Mountain is based on a handful of sequences that feature 1946 Disney movie Song of the South. While some may remember seeing the film, you wouldn't find it on Disney Plus. With the number of people urging Disney to save Splash Mountain, it's worth contemplating why the closure of the ride has been decided. So why is the Song of the South considered racist? Okay, so let's find this out here. Song of the South is considered racist by some adult audiences who argues it offers a romanticized and fabricated acceptance of life on a plantation from the perspective of an African-American in post-Civil War South. Ultimately, accusations of racism stem from the portrayal of central character Uncle Remus, portrayed by James Baskett. He's presented as a storyteller who essentially offers the film's gateway into the animated world of Briar Rabbit, which features in the Splash Mountain ride. Although Uncle Remus is shown to be happy with life on the plantation, this is exactly what a number of audiences criticize. Okay, so that's it. He's on a plantation. We didn't realize that.
Oh, okay.
We didn't realize that. Yeah, okay. Well, that's not good. Yeah. Remember when they said that Sleeping Beauty was rape culture because the guy kissed her? Mm-hmm. That's something.
Yeah. Sleeping Beauty's very boring.
Well, the witch is good. Yeah, she's Maleficent.
Good, yeah.
It's great.
Yeah.
It's actually scary. The scene where Maleficent first shows up, Sleeping Beauty, is actually, you're like, oh, God, for kids? Like, some of the Disney movies, when you look back, were, like, actually very dark.
Yeah. Pinocchio is nuts.
Yeah.
Kids getting turned into donkeys. And
thrown in an island.
Yeah.
Some of the Disney shit is weird.
Sold into slavery.
Yeah, some of it's odd.
Yeah, it's odd.
Some of you watch it back and you go, this is strange.
Yeah.
But a lot of those, like, fables, like, even the Grimm's fairy tales back in the day were very dark. Dark. Sometimes they were just dark things where they were trying to teach you a lesson.
Mm-hmm. These kids got to learn.
So somebody tweeted, shout out to the very confused family from Chicago trying to navigate Magic Kingdom, asking literally anyone and everyone, what is going on? Is it always like this? This is the last ride of Splash Mountain. So they had one more ride, and now they're going to rebuild the ride and make it less racist.
Can't they just, but what are they going to do? You can still call it Splash Mountain and have that was the best ride at Disney World.
I think they may still call it Splash Mountain, but I think they're going to, the theme is going to be different. I don't know what the new, they're selling water from Splash Mountain. I mean, people that are in Disney are sick.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because anyone who buys water from the Splash Mountain ride is sick.
Yeah.
And I guess they're changing the entire ride.
It's going to be LGBT themed.
Probably.
Splash Mountain.
The flume is a dick that goes right through someone's ass.
You can take pictures of yourself the moment that you go through the ass.
What if Disney did that? They just paint you in a little penis boat,
mm-hmm.
and you have to go through, and then the whole ride is they talk about the AIDS crisis,
mm-hmm.
and then you just go down the flume and you go right through an ass.
Yeah.
Fun ride.
Ben Shapiro's like, I went to Disney World. I had to go through an ass.
I had no idea what was going on. I sat in a penis boat, and I went through an ass.
You know, he's like a Disney guy.
Really?
He's like a Disney adult, yeah.
Yeah, he seems like it.
Yeah.
He seems like a little bit of a freak.
Yeah.
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 Remember he said his wife's pussy was never wet?
Yeah.
He goes, it's not wet. It's never been wet.
Yeah.
What is wet now?
Yeah.
Like, he seems like a guy that would get a little too into Disney World.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Where you go, like, yeah, this is not great.
Mm-hmm.
This is not great.
Yeah.
I had some friends where I grew up with where they were really into it.
Yeah, my cousin went on the Disney cruise for his honeymoon,
yeah.
which was strange.
Not good.
Yeah. Were you fucking on the...
It's kind of a problem.
You're supposed to fuck on your honeymoon.
There's something about going on a Disney cruise if you don't have kids, I guess I get it with the kids.
Yeah.
I totally get it. But without kids, odd.
Yeah.
I wonder if they're going to do a totally different ride. Does it say anything? Like, I wonder if they're going to destroy it and start over or if they're going to just.
Yeah.
Just as a new theme.
New theme. What's a theme? Like, I wonder what the theme's going to be.
Yeah, what other Disney movies are, like, water-related?
Do they do Avatar?
Maybe.
Is Avatar Disney? It's Pixar.
It's, yeah, no, it's...
No?
What, well, I don't Princess know what and the Frog ride.
That's what it's going to be?
Yep.
Oh.
Oh, New Orleans theme.
All right, that's fine.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
A Bayou Adventure. They'll find a way to make that racist.
Yeah. All right, look. Yeah. Okay,
yeah.
I went a little far with that.
Yeah, yeah. Guys... How about we not do any, like, just do something futuristic?
Yeah.
You're like, Song of the South's done. You're like, what are you doing now? We're going to the bayou.
It's narrated by Cat Williams.
Yeah.
The new log flume.
They're going to the bayou. They're going to call it, like, the Hurricane Katrina, you know?
Yeah.
They're, going to do something where people are going to go, this is
it's
not
gonna be,
better.
It's going to be Paul Mooney Splash Mountain. They're just going to play Paul Mooney clips.
Now, let me tell you. Tiana's Bayou Adventure. Is set to open late 2024 at Disney World and Disney World's Magic Kingdom. The company.
Now, I didn't see that movie. Did you see that movie?
Not at all.
Yeah. I heard it was good.
Tiana's Bayou Adventure.
Did you watch the new Velma on HBO, the Mindy Kaling show?
No.
Did you see it, Hunter?
My friends did. They said it sucked, though.
Yeah, it's bad. It's like mentally ill.
Why is it bad?
It's just
everything
it's
is
just,
bad.
Yeah, it's, everything's bad. Yeah.
But what's the problem?
It's just like about her. It's just like about it's just like her story kind of, but she just using the Scooby-Doo characters.
Who cares about Velma?
Yeah.
It's like they made a Lord of the Rings. It's all about Galadriel, who's just like a cold elf princess. Mm-hmm. It's like she's not supposed to be the fucking...
Yeah, nobody watched that show, huh?
Nobody
watched that.
It's about Galadriel.
Yeah.
That's not the focal point of the... They're like, well, women should be centered. Then write another one.
Write a
Don't
new
write another thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
You don't have to go back to an old world and grab a female character that wasn't central and make
and what,
her central.
It's like her fucking origin story. Yeah. Didn't that thing cost $1 billion to make?
Like,
and it's just
I'm
like
Galadriel. You know?
What are we doing?
Long, long ago in a world far, far away.
You know what show doesn't do that?
Yeah.
Tulsa King on Paramount Plus.
You keep plugging Tulsa King.
It's the best show
on TV. Let's get the trailer for Tulsa
King.
It's the best
show on TV.
I don't know. I think it might be retarded, but it might not
be. It might be retarded. I don't know if I'm a smart guy or a dumb guy.
We're going to, you know what's going to tell us? The trailer of Tulsa King.
Okay.
Let's watch this.
You know, it's just like, I try to watch a little bit of everything.
Hold on.
I don't know what you're expecting now that you're back.
I'm expecting adequate compensation.
Tulsa.
What's Tulsa?
I want you to go there. The horse race, the Springboard Mile. There's nobody doing nothing. You can do whatever you want.
Not exactly the welcome I was expecting.
Name's Tyson. Welcome to Tulsa.
$2,000 a week. You drive for me now. What crew runs this neighborhood?
No crew up in here. We're in the middle of nowhere.
What'll it be?
I assume you don't have Keanu.
You assume correctly.
Taylor Sheridan's good.
He's good.
He's good.
I'll tell you what, this is a show.
He wrote Yellowstone. He knows what he's doing. So even though this does look a little dumb, I would watch this.
You know exactly what's happening the whole time.
That's right.
There's no, like I tried to watch Andor, that Disney Plus show.
Okay.
You go like, oh, they're trying to say something about like colonialism and, and they're doing Star Wars, but they're trying to make it about whatever. And you go, all right, I guess I can kind of follow this. It's very dense.
Right.
You miss a lot of the show.
Of course.
This is like, I know exactly what's happening. He fucks this lady, and then she goes, he tells her that he's 75, and she leaves the hotel room.
Yeah. She's like, he's a mob guy.
Yeah.
Got out of jail. He's going to Tulsa.
Yeah.
That's the pitch.
He kept his mouth shut.
Yeah. He's being rewarded. He's going to Tulsa.
And it's a boomer show, but it's very, like, self-aware. Like, he's very much, like, a loser in this show. He's very much a guy who, like, made bad decisions.
Right.
And he's trying to fix his life.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I think that's probably not the worst show out
it's
there.
The best show.
Okay. I'm willing to buy into that.
Yeah.
I'm willing to believe
it. No, if you need a show to watch, I mean, yeah, you would like it. I really liked it.
Yeah.
Watched
I'm waiting for Euphoria to come back.
Never saw it.
I love it.
Yeah.
I think it's great.
It's just like hot teens.
They're not teens. Like, they're adults.
Yeah.
They're playing teens.
They're playing teens.
And they're not all hot.
Oh, no? Okay.
Some of them are.
That's good.
But then the rest of them are gross. There's like two hot ones. There's Jacob Elordi and Zendaya. And then maybe there's a couple, you know. Oh, Sydney Sweeney is hot. But yeah, if they're all on junk and they're all fucked up. I mean, it's the American teenage
experience.
But
I thought they canceled Euphoria.
No. See, HBO's biggest show. Oh, okay. One of them.
I thought they canceled it. And
it's actually
like
a really good show. Like, there's like the father like comes out as gay. He's like, I suck cock. And like his kids are there and his wife's standing there and she's like, go to bed. He's like, I fucked a lot of guys. Like, it's a very, it's a dark show.
Yeah.
It's a dark show, but it's good.
Yeah.
Good. There's not much out there right now that is good.
No, everything's kind of.
You know
like-
what's good? Wednesday on Netflix, it's silly and they copied Harry Potter.
Okay.
But it's actually, as a silly show goes,
yeah,
not bad.
Yeah.
If you, if you're interested in, like, why is it the biggest show?
Yeah.
The watch it. The girl, Jenna Ortega, is insanely good in it.
Nice. The Trump years were bad for TV and
they
for
weren't good.
You know, because nobody knew what to say.
Nobody knew what to do.
Yeah.
And everybody was trying to, you know,
but
make things that are, I think things are
like
coming
relevant
back now.
Everyone had to use their platform to like fight fascism.
That's right.
You know,
that's when we got some. Well, we listen. We had, what did we have? We had Game of Thrones. There were some things during the Trump
years. That was Obama, though. Didn't it come out in like 2011?
Yeah. When did it end?
It ended probably in like 2018, 2019.
Yeah. Yeah. I can't remember.
2019, I want to say.
There was a few good things that came out during the Trump years.
What? I don't. Yeah.
In my head, I'm trying to think.
I'm trying to
Euphoria
think
is one of them.
The movie, I guess, Get Out came out in 2017.
Get Out.
It was good.
There was
Uncut Gems.
Uncut Gems was fucking amazing.
We saw Sandler at Nobu today.
Yeah.
We didn't see him, but I noticed.
He was there.
Yeah.
He was, he's a resident.
Yeah.
One of the most awesome days of the month is when our box of awesome from Bespoke Post arrives. So we're just going to go ahead and unbox this thing right now and tell you guys what we got. One of the coolest things in my Bespoke Post is the lighter that is sent to me. And every month I am sent, what do they call this? A cradle for the coffee? That's in my Bespoke Post. They send me a cactus every month, and also this, and then this key. We don't know what it's for, but that's my box of awesome every month. It's amazing. It's one of the coolest things. Every unique item is hand-curated from a small business that you would never have heard of otherwise. The great thing about Bespoke Post is when you give a gift to somebody, they're getting a new box every single month of really cool stuff, and it feels like they're like, oh my God, I love this person. Every month, they remember how good you were to them. So go to boxofawesome.com and enter the code Tim Dillon at checkout. That's boxofawesome.com. Code Tim Dillon for 20% off your first box, boxofawesome.com. So I'm excited about, I love a House of Cards new season.
Mm.
Spacey.
Yeah.
Robin Wright.
Right.
He's back from the dead.
Yeah, no one's going to, I mean, he already killed that guy. So no one's, I don't think he's going to be a problem again. Nobody wants to get murdered.
He had a few accusers. He killed two of them.
Right.
Let him back.
Let him back.
What's the problem?
Yeah.
He's not going to, you know, no one's going to come forward now.
No.
You'd have to be an idiot.
You'd have to be an idiot to molest and to blow the whistle on it.
No, you just have to you take it.
Yeah. Well, you know, no one wants to take risks in Hollywood. That's the problem with this town. No one wants to.
You put a good, you good, because that last season of House of Cards was an abortion. It was an aberration. Was it? It was horrible.
Yeah.
But if you just say, hey, we're doing it again.
Yeah.
And everybody's going back. We're going to be okay.
What'd you think of Many Saints in Newark?
Hated it.
I mean, yeah, nobody liked it.
Hated it.
Yeah, hated it. Terrible.
Hated it.
Yeah.
But I hated The Irishman, too.
You did? Yeah.
I'm just over that whole genre.
Some people like The Irishman. Like, there. I mean, there's one comic that said that thinks it's better than Goodfellas. Renan Hirschberg thinks it's better than Goodfellas.
He's crazy.
That's crazy. But I tried to rewatch it. No one
thinks
that.
Here's the thing. When you have a take that no one thinks, it's bad.
It's bad, yeah.
This is just, it's not, you're not unique.
Yeah. You're not,
It's not a contrarian take. Uh-huh. It's a bad take.
Yeah.
When no one feels that way except you, you're having a moment that's crazy.
He should be harassed online for that opinion.
I mean, what's his justification for that?
I don't know.
It's an objectively bad film.
Bad. The Irishman.
The Irishman.
Yeah. It took me like a week to watch it, to get through it. I watched it. And then recently I was like, maybe I should rewatch The Irishman. Because maybe it is a good movie. Because I had Matt Kreisman on my old podcast and we talked about it. And he kind of like brought up some points about why it was actually good. Because it's about the end of the genre. So like this genre's over. The mob movie's over.
Okay. Well, if I looked at it as that.
Maybe if,
then I could reframe. Yeah.
But it's not, there's nothing fun about it. And I started watching it and I was like, I don't
know. Why not look at Song of the South like that? We go, racism's over.
Yeah.
It's the end of end of racism.
Right.
This ride is actually the end of racism.
Yeah. It's they should screen it at Metrograph, actually.
It's the end.
They should have Dasha do a Q&A.
Yeah. Well, I find that. That's fine. I just couldn't get into The Irishman. I want Scorsese to like challenge himself and make movies about trans people and like and like drag queens. Sure. I want the next Scorsese movie to be all drag. What about an all drag queen mafia movie?
Just call it Story Hour.
Story Hour, and it's just drag queens with they're defending themselves against the Proud Boys.
Yeah, that's fun. Or you could do Tulsa King.
It is a little weird. People showing up with guns to the Story Hour.
It is very weird.
Feels like it's a bit much.
It feels a little excessive.
And I think Story Hour is forced. It's forced.
Yeah.
Because I don't think anyone wants to read to kids. It's boring.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But obviously, if you have a kid, it's important to read to them. But like nobody is like, oh, it's Wednesday. Yeah. I gotta, unless you're like a lonely old woman.
Mm-hmm.
That's who should do Story Hour, like lonely old women who are like, I have nothing.
Yeah.
I have nothing at all. And then they're like, and every Wednesday, this old bitch looks forward to going to read to these kids.
Yeah, but COVID wiped them out. So you got to go to the next rung on the ladder, which is drag queens. It's from lonely old women.
And then what are those guys? You show up with guns. It seems like a bit much.
Yeah, it is a bit much. It
seems a bit much.
Yeah. But then you go like, well, what about the, you know, like, is it weird to take a kid to a drag show? Maybe not. I don't know.
It depends.
It depends. Yeah.
It's odd. You have a kid. I don't have a kid.
Yeah.
So I feel like kids would see drag queens like clowns.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Wouldn't they not even understand? Like, unless it's like very sexualized, the show.
No, but the reaction to it, is much crazier.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I don't think drag shows are appropriate for kids. Like if they're at like drag bar, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But if a kid sees a drag queen do it like at a brunch or something.
Yeah.
Wouldn't they just be like, oh, it's a clown?
Yeah.
Like, because drag queens kind of look like clowns.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I don't know. That seems to be
what
I would think. But people get very, it's a cultural battleground.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm not as familiar with it.
Why do we still have libraries?
Yeah, I don't know.
Why is there even a place to do this? Why do we have, like, it's a good question. Why are there libraries?
Yeah. It's just like, a waste of money.
It's a waste of
that money could be going to war.
It's a waste of money. It should be to go for the Ukraine.
Yeah. Yeah, we could. Yeah.
Nobody goes to libraries.
Ukraine or Israel.
Israel deserves more
money.
Close
the libraries and send the money to Israel.
How much money do they need to beat the Palestinians? Palestinians have no weapon. They have like nothing.
Yeah, but they have the
rockets.
They have God on their side.
They have the rockets and Allah on their side. Do you think that's the way Israel presented to the United States? Or like, listen, I know they, the United States is like, how much money?
I know they live in mud, but they do have the power of.
Yeah. They have Allah and they have God on their side. And the United States is like, that's a good point. Yeah. Here's another $3 billion.
Look, you have to remember, we are evil and no one likes us. Because we shoot children and journalists in the head.
Dude, Barry White's the best thing ever. She was on my podcast. I'm like, but you shell schools with the kids in them. She's like, we also have to shell hospitals. I'm like, that's your defense?
Yeah.
So I was like, that's the defense? She's like, yeah, because that's where Hamas, like, fucking, they use shields of children. I'm like, that's an odd defense.
She's kind of a ding-dong, huh?
Well, she's very into that nation.
Yeah.
She's smart. Barry's smart.
Yeah.
But
well, that's the thing. People who are into Israel, they really like it.
She's smart, and she's clearly smart, but she's really relentlessly pro-Israel. Mm-hmm. Like, if Ireland did half the things Israel did, I'd go, oh, fuck that. Like, I'm not as deep in.
Sure. But then you can make the argument if the children are, then the children are not human shields if you're blowing them up, right?
Right. That's a good point.
I heard it on Chapo.
Yeah. She's into it. She's into Israel.
Mm-hmm.
That's her beat.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
And she came on and she made some arguments. I had Abby Martin on too. I had Abby on and then people yelled at me, so I had Barry on. And then people yelled at me, and then I should have had nobody on.
Right.
Because what did we solve here?
Yeah.
It's the whole thing. You have these people on.
Yeah.
One side goes nuts.
Yeah.
Then you have the other person on. The other side goes nuts. And I'm like, oh, I'm an Irish guy from Long Island. Right, why am I inserting myself into this?
But look at the power dynamics.
Centuries long feud.
Yeah. But no, it's not centuries long. It's like decades long.
Well, isn't they're beefing about biblical shit, kind of.
I don't think so.
Kind of. They seem to be.
I think people want you to believe that the conflict is like complicated.
Yeah.
So that you like stay out of it. And you're anti-Semitic if you say anything about it.
You know, I am not that educated about it. Mm-hmm. All that I've always thought about it is that it seems weird that you keep building settlements.
Yeah.
And you keep pushing the borders out.
Bulldozing, yeah.
And that seems very antagonistic.
Yeah.
But I don't.
And they shot that journalist in the head.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You know, but the beef seems to go back.
Did you see that? Abby Martin put out that documentary and she's interviewing people in Israel and they're like, she's like, well, so how do you think we solve the problem? And they're like, it's very difficult, but.
I saw the documentary.
I think maybe what you have to do is kill them all.
Yeah, she came on my show. We talked about the doc she made. Yeah, Gaza Fights for Freedom.
She's cool. What's she like in real life?
She's cool.
Yeah, she's cool.
Cool, you know?
Yeah.
I laid back.
But at the end of the day, what are you going to do about
this?
What
am I going to do about that? You know what I mean? Are they buying tickets?
Yeah, right.
Palestinians really buying tickets? You know what I mean? Like, let's cut the shit. Yeah, it's like... Yeah, yeah. You know, I mean, listen, I don't want anything to happen to them, but I have no control over what Israel does.
No.
So it's like, and all these podcasts can talk endlessly about everything. No one cares.
Yeah.
So just make your money.
Let's watch that 8-year-old again.
Yeah. No, but that's better entertainment. It's like, that's the thing TLC realizes. Uh-huh. TLC gets it.
They get it a little bit.
They go, you know what? Here's the reality. We're just going to put a girl on who looks 8 and see who will fuck her.
Uh-huh.
That's the reality. Yeah. Imagine a TLC show called Understanding the Middle East.
Right, right.
That's not doing numbers.
Sometimes you got to just shut your brain. I wonder what the percentage of people who watch these shows that have like PhDs and stuff, you know?
Interesting.
They just want to shut their brains off.
They
want to
shut their brains off and just watch somebody who's 600
watch
pounds.
Watch a couple with Down syndrome who fucks the shit out of each other.
Yeah. I mean, there's something nice about that. Somebody goes, Shauna Rae, I just love watching this show. Shauna is such a beautiful, sweet young lady. And seeing how she handles the struggle she has in life is really inspiring. I understand her need
this
for independence.
This is great. It's half 5-star reviews and half 1-star reviews.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some people love it.
You would go to a restaurant that had reviews like that.
Yeah. Some people really like it.
Yeah.
My wife and I have fallen in love with this family. Okay. The next one. I was expecting more from TLC. Mm-hmm. We all know reality TV is based upon editing and setting up particular scenarios to keep viewers coming back. But this show literally places this young lady in a situation every episode where her age is put into question. Be it in a bar, amusement park ride, tattoo parlor, sex shop. It's so cornball. You can almost see it coming a mile away. They put her in a sex shop?
Today we're going to... we're going to find me a dildo.
I'm getting a dildo today at a sex shop. I'm really excited. I'm really excited to go to the pleasure chest to get a dildo.
Try to find that episode of the sex shop.
Shauna Rae.
I love how we did a 5-minute Israel recap.
Guys, if you don't want to hear the Israel-Palestine stuff.
But you immediately start circling the drain with that where you go, I don't. Yeah, it is unfair that the Palestinians live like that, you know?
It is. Yeah. Mike and Tim get real about Israel and Palestine.
It's like, I don't think they should live like that. And maybe they would buy
tickets.
Yeah,
well, it's funny because the people that you meet, like that you meet in the world who are like into Israel are really into it. they're almost like Disney adults where you go, oh, you really like this thing. You know, like, you know how like Sam Morrell, he loves the Knicks.
Yes.
You know, you go like, well, I don't want to like take that away from you because you love this thing so much.
A lot of Jewish people I know don't even care though.
Yeah.
But then some people care the most.
Some people care the most. Yeah. Well, that's because that's where they got fingered.
Right. They went on their thing.
They went on birthright. That's and got right. fingered. Yeah.
So now this is Mind Your Business. Now, is she from Long Island? So that I know that Sex Shop Expressions, I've passed it a million times. It's on, I think it's off Sunrise Highway. Uh-huh. Let's watch this scene. Go back to the beginning. Let's see this. Shauna is at a sex shop.
Oh, she tells the word. Hey, sweetheart, where's your mom?
She's.
Hello, how are you guys?
Jesus.
You guys looking for anything specific?
What about the kid working there? He's like 15.
Gotcha. Yeah. It's going to be over in that direction.
He's Eric got his first job.
Yeah, he's smitten.
He's getting married, and we recently went bridesmaid dress shopping.
The boobs are too big.
Everything is too big. It's not just the boobs.
Can I wear my combat boots?
No.
Sorry.
While she's been planning the wedding, we've been planning the bachelorette party. So this afternoon, we're going shopping for some supplies.
What do you think would make her the most uncomfortable?
I am getting married to my fiance, Jesse. We're originally from
Jesse Smollett.
So I thought Pittsburgh is the perfect place to celebrate me getting married.
And I still have friends there.
Banana ringtone.
Don't you have to hold it?
No, you put it in between your legs.
Yeah, you have to hold it with your legs. That's weird. So grab the banana one.
Yeah.
I'm extremely nervous that Riley and Shauna are going to surprise me with some raunchy stuff at this bachelorette party. I do not want it to be gross. I don't want it to be raunchy.
Why don't we grab a pack of each confetti?
So that sickos, we can watch and crack. Make
you
this
want two bags of
crazy.
Sure, that's more annoying.
Hello, can I see some ID?
Do I need to take it out for you? Or do you, like, do you need to scan it?
No.
I'm 40.
Okay. And then.
Once on my accessory post.
Gotcha. My first thought was, is that a kid? I was a little shocked at first, but, you know, I was.
Are those hickeys all over his neck? At least
once I found out that she was an adult, both of them were.
Apparently. Some other customers in the store had the employee there come up to us and ask for our IDs. When people want to verify my
Qatar should just buy this network.
Most of the time, it's not for the business. It's not for.
Okay, things are going to be a little different at the TLC network. Yeah. They have to.
It's just funny. It's like, you know, all these people on the right wing are like, America's just descending. It's a moral collapse. It's degeneracy. It's everything. And you're like, oh, it's a little extreme. And then you're like. Like an 8-year-old girl. It's like, well, yeah, I mean, maybe they have a little bit of a point.
What, Antifa's not watching this show.
Yeah, who is watching this show?
Or nosiness. I'm not looking at you and looking at what sex toys you're buying and making sure I'm checking your ID.
Fuck out of here. This is like.
One penis pinata, please. For me, 23-year-old Shauna.
Going for playing with. I'm going to make her uncomfortable.
What penis pinata, please?
Yeah. Okay, then we grab it.
But she doesn't even act like a 23.
No, dude, she's not 23.
Is that a pun?
No, but it is now. Tara's definitely the most different between the three of us.
Yeah, she's the most
conservative.
Shauna's the one that pushes, like, the raunchy envelope.
She's probably got a stage mom, and she's like, yeah, so this is my daughter, and she's 23 because she had brain cancer. Yeah, that's what we're going with. Can you give us a reality show?
Hey, we'd like a reality show. My daughter will date adult men.
Okay, we can't call the show My 8-Year-Old Daughter Dates Adult Men, so we're going to have to lie and say she's...
Listen, we're thinking about doing something here where my daughter, she's 23, but she looks, like, that's the pitch in the TLC room. They go,
yeah.
She's 23, but she looked 8. Everyone at the DLC, all the executives go, oh. Mm-hmm. And they go, it's hard for her to find love. And they go, well, of course. And they go, yes, we're just going to do a show where she gets kicked out of bars and sex shops. It'll humiliate her.
Yeah.
And then we'll attract maybe probably pedophiles to come have sex with her. We'll put it on television. We'll put it on TV. What's the problemo?
The like, raunchiness.
Yes, in like public or like with our family, like our parents, it's like she has something to prove. Like she is an adult and she is able to talk about this stuff.
Anything else?
I think we're good.
Are you sure?
Got too much.
Because I could shop all day.
I know you could.
I'm dropping, sir.
Oh, come on. You can put that on the camera, Shauna.
No, I really can't. I'm fighting. We ended up getting some party games. We got confetti.
Vibrator.
She's gonna kill us. It's gonna be worth it.
She looks young too.
What's better than doing this to her conservative sister? I hope Tara's reaction will be good. It depends on the mood Tara's in, of course, though. If Tara's not in a good mood when we give her the gifts,
what
she's
are you doing? Please
house.
Stop. Please do not make the show anymore. Your people are bad. You people are not going to go to heaven. You understand that, yes?
Bring the Indian doctor on.
Let me.
Thank you.
These are surprisingly heavy.
Okay, I can take.
You're 23. Let me see your pussy. Hold on. Let me. I want to touch your pussy. I will tell you if she's 23 for real.
I must do an inspection to see if you're 23. Is your pussy 23 or not?
That doctor's great. He's so over all the bullshit. He's so tired of being lied to by 600 pound people. No, I'm actually down. No, I'm actually only 550.
No, you're not. Stop lying to my face.
Don't fuck with me anymore. Don't fuck with me anymore. All you do is eat.
Do you think I'm fucking
asshole? Get him up. Get this Indian doctor up.
Do you think I'm fucking asshole, man? Do you think I'm fucking stupid, man?
I want you to stop with the bullshit. I know all you do, eat all day. You sit, you eat.
This is an 8-year-old pussy.
Your 8-year-old pussy? This is great. After a bad weigh-in, Lee gets it.
This is great. This is awesome.
How y'all doing?
Surviving.
This guy's
surviving,
amazing.
Huh?
Wait.
So is that why you missed your last appointment? You just had your bypass about 2 months ago. And when you left the hospital, you were down to 546. So you lost only...
That's your car outside the Oscar Mayer Weenie Mobile? That's what you drive?
Lost almost 50 pounds at the same time. And she hasn't even had her bypass yet. What in the world is going on?
Dude, watching people lie.
Hold on. Go back. I want to.
Watching people lie is so funny.
It's amazing. I want to hear what she said because, like, this is amazing. Hold on.
Nay has lost almost 50 pounds at the same time, and she hasn't even had her bypass yet. What in the world is going on with you?
I guess I'm eating wrong things.
You think it's funny? You have a gastric bypass.
I had a gastric bypass,
To lose weight. And you're not losing weight.
I don't eat a third what I ate before I had
that question,
surgery.
Okay. Then
you're
we're not
asking
talking
me
about
questions
that
I don't understand no more than you understand.
What are you talking about? You're choosing to overeat, and you think it's okay?
No, I don't think it's okay.
I'm sorry, my ride's here.
Now listen, if you die, they're going to do a show with an 8-year-old girl who is really 23.
Is that what you want?
Is that what you want? You want an 8-year-old who's 23 go by? She go by dildos? They're going to
this
film
is what's
her.
On the line. Everyone at TLC, no one go to heaven. They all go to hell because we. This is the most moral show that is on the TLC. You
it's
understand?
The only show that I can sleep a little bit, knowing that I am a part of. If you die, they're going to bring in a girl to get dildo. She's a child. A child.
They're going to buy. Yeah, that show is actually the.
It's the only one.
It's the Ghost of Christmas Future of TLC.
TLC, if they cancel this fucking show. The evil of TLC is beyond human comprehension.
Yeah.
Here, let's watch a little bit more of this. This guy's amazing.
I guess I'm not eating the right things. I mean,
we gave you the instruction that you need to follow, and you never follow. You play your cards right until you got the surgery.
Does not feel bad
and
for these people.
Now you're playing this kind of game, and you think that's okay? How in the world
don't
somebody?
How I'm playing any game. I throw up constantly. I eat what I can keep down.
I have a that's Mexican man goes. In my office. He says somebody steal my hot dog cart. He said he's looking for it. That's how he feeds his family. And he's and I think you stole it, because you come in here with hot dog cart. I say, what is that? And you say, it's my wheelchair. It's not a wheelchair. That is that man's livelihood that you have with you.
You don't understand. Next week I inspect an 8-year-old girl pussy because. You die because you eat too much shit.
You throw up constantly because the surgery forces you to when you overeat now.
I think my problem is I'm holding a lot of fluid. I can't hardly pee.
Really?
I mean, I don't know what.
That
I mean,
man said you take all his cotton candy. That's how he feed his 8 kids. And you just steal his cotton candy. You are a fucking evil.
When you feel full up, you have to stop. When you feel full up in your stomach, you have to stop. That is the end. The end.
What's in that big gulp? Is that canola oil in your big gulp cup? You're just drinking canola oil, and why you lie to me?
Yeah. What do you mean you don't know? And you think that you're not eating, and you gave me
I don't like malnourished either.
Do you look like you're malnourished? You're overeating, and whatever you're overeating, you're torn up. It means the surgery is working to hold you back when you make bad choices. And it's the only reason that
can you believe this?
100 pounds.
I don't have to listen to this.
Much.
Do you not want me to eat at all?
You know that's not what I'm saying at all. You have been given a tool to help you change your life. Now that you had the surgery, the physical drive to eat is gone. So you have to deal with what is driving you to eat. That's the hard part, and you don't want to do it. And you're running from it and self-destructing.
I'm done with this conversation.
I'm done with this conversation.
No, we're gonna finish with you.
No,
I might just waddle out of here right now.
Right
if you insult me again.
By the way, she's got him against the door.
Wait, sit down.
Okay.
Let go of me, Renee.
All right, this is completely unacceptable.
Goddamn. This man should be on every single reality TV show.
Yeah, every single one.
He should be on To Catch a Predator.
Yeah.
And what happened when you say, I want to suck your 14-year-old cock? Yeah. You thought that was okay?
He is the Real Housewife. Oh, what's his name? Dr. What?
Dr.
Lee.
Yunan. No, Zardan.
Oh, it says a doctor from my 600-pound life.
We should make an origin story about him. You should write a movie. It's his origin story.
I love him like he goes to the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. He's like, you're all rich cunts. You'll sit and argue about dinner parties. People in my country that drink bad water that die. You stupid bitch. You eat in Malibu. You argue with this other bitch.
He's on Kitchen Nightmares. Why you call this the taco pizza? It's not taco. It's not pizza.
Yeah. You keep doing heroin, it's no good. Intervention with Dr.
The computer duster is not for your brain. It's bad for your brain, you know that.
This is where he loses it with a patient.
I'm wasting my time coming here, bringing all the people working for you. Amazing. And you do nothing.
In an attempt
amazing.
To where are they now?
I don't have to listen to you. I don't have to listen.
You piece of shit.
I love podcasting, baby.
Oh, it's so great.
I have an elementary school gym teacher. He says, someone steal my parachute. Does that, are you wearing the parachute? Is the, that your clothing?
Like, they have to explain to him that the next show they're doing is about a child bride. And he's just sitting there. He goes, I have dealt with fat people. I've dealt with Down syndrome people. This is now too much. You say to me, we give you more money, but I want to go to heaven. Now don't you give me no jive. Don't give me no jive.
I don't know what you told your homies, but you're not going to lie to me. Okay, sister girl. I don't know what Redman and Method Man say to you about your weight, but you are too fat. You look like Patrice O'Neal.
She's not even that overweight. What's
She's
happening here?
She's not big at all.
My 600.
I'm doing much better.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, and you're down to 306 pounds.
Yes, sir.
But you are doing well and staying on track.
Oh, good.
But your weight
they replaced Simon Cowell with him on American Idol.
You dropped to losing only 16 pounds a month, and now you're down to losing...
Tim, I got a reality show. Yeah. We get this guy to judge like an open mic.
You're not so funny at all. I don't care that you're gay.
Yeah.
It does not matter to me. All you people get in here. You move to Brooklyn. You come on the stage. You say, I'm gay. I'm gay.
You're bisexual. Oh, you are bisexual.
You're all bisexual. I don't care about your degenerate lifestyle. Do you have any joke? Do you have one joke in your degenerate lifestyle?
Oh, really? You are brown? That is so interesting. Not good.
Yeah, there are a billion brown people with more talent in the mouth of a tiger right now. Mike, you're seeing anything to promote.
I got a bunch of
too much
stuff.
Fun.
Yeah, I know. I should move that.
We should put
here.
This out on YouTube.
This is a great episode.
And we should just put it out on YouTube and see what happens. I mean, maybe we got...
Just that segment,
people
yeah.
aren't going to... No, we're going to put the whole hour out.
Okay, great.
The whole thing out on YouTube.
That'd
and you know what?
Amazing. I
people
would love
get
that.
Angry, and that's fine.
Who would get angry?
I don't know. I'm
some
sure
fucking
someone,
fat bitch.
That eight-year-old.
Some 800-pound whore who's going to be dead in a couple days. Come on, who cares?
Mike Racine.
It's comedy, baby. I got a podcast called Out for Smokes. It's a lot of fun. I do it with Sean McCarthy and Scott Chaplin. I got some road dates, Baltimore, Boston, Denver, Cleveland, and I'm taping a special in New York City at the end of February.
Fuck yeah.
February 26th at The Stand. I would love to get some people out at the show for that.
And, 100%.
Yeah.
I'm bringing a gun.
Follow me on Instagram if you can, at Mike Racine Comedy. All my dates are
and
in my
Twitter.
Bio and everything.
Give Twitter.
At Mike Racine on Twitter.
Okay.
But yeah, Instagram's where.
Later this week, I'm bringing a gun to the Beverly Wilshire Hotel to try to get something going over there. TimDillaComedy.com for all the live shows. I'm not going to go through them all. We get it. Go to TimDillaComedy.com and go to a bunch of places. We just put Palm Beach up, and it's always fun over there. A lot of reasonable people. this is reasonable. They're reasonable people. Mike Racine, one of my oldest friends in comedy. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you.
Beautiful wife and kid.
Thanks, buddy.
And thank this guy.
Thank you. Thank you, my friend.
Thank you. Goodbye.